Guys, I have a confession to make. I
love haters! Hey, 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 hey.
What's up, guys? For today's video, we're gonna be talking about something that has happened to people very recently a lot in social media. So if you're familiar with Doc Adam, an Australian doctor who speaks in Tagalog, our native language, to help educate people in my country about medical facts and trying to fight off dangerous medical disinformation. You have people like Pokimane who had a lot of feedback or actually criticism and hate about things like allowing fans to simp for her. And maybe even Donald Trump, even if he's not a content creator, he's a social media personality. He's also been getting a lot of hate actually for the past 4 years. Anyway, guys, what today we're going to be talking about is how to deal with hateful comments, hateful chats, and generally people who think it's cool to actually say bad things to you and say very terrible things to you even on your channel. So let's get to it. So the first tip that I will tell you guys about dealing with haters is, first of all, remember that it is your space, okay? Your channel, your stream, your video, your post, etc., etc. Whenever anyone interacts or goes and watches any of the content that you put out in whatever channel and whatever platform you use, it is your house, okay? So think about it this way. You're an Uber or a Grab driver, depending on where you are in the world, and you obviously open up your car, which is your property, to other people to sit in so that you can take them from place to place. You're offering them a service. But since your passengers are paying customers, does that mean they have the authority to vandalize your car, to steal your car, to wreck your car while they're sitting in there? Nope. They don't have that authority, and that's really, really absurd. It's the same thing. Whenever you get hate comments that are uncalled for and really below the belt and maybe even racist or sexist or whatever, they're vandalizing basically your space. And that's the first thing that you have to remember, right? It's your space. Don't let them get the better of you because that's your channel. You have the authority. Whatever goes on there is your space and they're only allowed to go there and stay there if they're following the rules. The same way that you kick people out of the car if they're stealing or breaking stuff or they're obviously very hostile towards you. That's the first thing. Don't be ashamed at the desire to actually protect your space. Don't be ashamed of actually doing that. The second tip that I'm going to be sharing with you is to make sure that you draw your lines and what to do whenever someone crosses it. Okay. In my case, since I do educational videos, there are two types of comments, actually, in general, negative comments that I face on every video. The first one are valid criticism. So this is when things they actually talk about their experience and real world experience versus me, or maybe they have an opinion that I haven't considered and they really write it out and really express it properly. And they tell me they're very polite or at least respectful or decent in terms of how they disagree with me. My response there is to actually dignify that with proper response. And I actually, depending on what happens, if it's they point out a mistake that I did, I obviously will acknowledge my mistake. I'll even pin their comment. If it was really a good comment, I'll pin that up so other people can see that. And basically, I reflect on that and see what I can improve or even actually experiment or take that feedback and take it in and make sure it goes into my, you know, different types of content moving forward. So that's the first type of comment. The second thing, though, is ad hominems. Basically, they are attacking me directly, and sometimes it's not even related to the content. So let's look at some of the hate comments that I've received.
Sana all silver spoon again, which is translated as I wish everyone had a silver spoon. Walang kwenta, translated as this is useless or this is trash. Ingit ka lang kasi potek, translated means you're just jealous, you oaf. And from this guy, Armando Salazar, this guy, under any circumstance, you should not buy the V8. Also this guy, we don't know what it's made of. We don't know what its internals are. I've never bought it. What's the point of this video then? Stupid. From okay, alright, solid eye bags nito, pwede na ikilo. Translated to, this guy has some serious eye bags. You can weigh and sell them.
Now for these types of comments, I usually relish them because I get this opportunity to roast them as well. They assume that I'm a YouTuber, a person that actually doesn't have fangs. Excuse me, bro. If you're coming here hot, you better get ready to get fire rain down on you as well. So let's take a look at my top favorite roasting responses to people who have posted negative stuff about my channel. I mean, not just negative stuff, like crazy ad hominem stuff. Let's see a couple of the things that I really liked saying to them. Let's watch it. So Erp Neething says, your point?
And I said, went above your head, unfortunately.
And GBCTV says, kung anong pangit ng mukha mo, pangit din ang content mo, yun lang yun. Ha 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 ha. Translated in English as, your content is as ugly as you are. That's it. And I looked at his videos, looks pretty cringy, and this is what I said. Bro, you mad because you can't afford a better sound setup? Who even gets mad at a tech video? Oh wait, someone like you who has trash vids and looks like someone you'd see drinking on a corner, lol. Void Place Official says, sana pwede makadislike ng marami sa streamer na to. Mata pobre ang pucha. Translated to English, it means, I hope a lot of people will dislike the streamer. Effing elitist. And this is what I told him. Sana pwede magbigay ng utak ng marami kay Void Place. Not gonna lie, if I posted videos like yours, I'd be insecure. What I said at the first part was, I hope people can give a lot of brains to Void Plays. And that next part is English. Now this interesting comment from Zeddy King says, I clicked on this video to see a legitimate review and I just got a lot of, I don't know if. And the reviewer doesn't even hands-on experience with it. At 808, he choked as he doesn't have anything to say when the singer sounds better than him. So I went to his videos and it's pretty cringy. He was using his mic wrong. It's not a review though. Also, checking your channel, your standard for good audio seems pretty low. Also, you're using the BM800 wrong, bro. It's a side address microphone. Like I keep saying, you don't need first-hand experience to call out stupidity. And I have a funny one, the last one. This is actually not a hater. This is one of the perp people on my stream. He commented, if I got it, can I make it pick up my fart? It was super funny. So I responded, yes. And it will also add a good amount of hiss. For best results, make sure to jam your microphone in the butt. Just kidding. So yeah, guys, it's very important for you to understand what the right response is. For me, if it's valid criticism, okay, I will take it in, analyze it, and acknowledge my mistake or correct that person if they really took the time to make a very decent, well-thought-out comment. But for the hominems, bro, you started it. I'm gonna fire back at you. But obviously, your response is gonna be different. And I would advise you to take a very nuanced approach. So if you're actually a public figure, don't respond to hate with hate. You know, just give them very witty responses that will be out of league for them to respond. On my case, I'm actually a person who enjoys like this banter anyway. So it's part of my brand to be able to roast all of these hateful comments on my channel. My third tip for you guys is to make sure that you just have fun with the hateful comments, okay? Don't take it too seriously. I know it hurts if people say some bad things to you. Like people have commented on my eye bags. People have commented on my looks. People have commented on my integrity. So don't worry about it. There's a lot of things that we can control in this world, but we can never control completely what others perceive about us. We can project power, right? We can project kindness. Like for example, Pokimane projects, you know, a wholesome, very innocent vibe, but obviously she has haters that think she's a very sinister person. We cannot control it. And no matter how much we could project or make people think or act the way that to make people think the way we want them to think, it's not always going to work. So we cannot control that. However, you can control your response to it, right? Whenever I am faced with a hateful comment, I first think about, okay, where is this person coming from? Is this person making sense? And I try to extract actual objective criticism from the trash, okay? Because sometimes, you know, it could be feedback that I'm doing something wrong. But after I've taken that out, okay, he's giving me feedback because of this. I just disregard everything else and I have fun with it, okay? I have fun with it. And another way to think about it is that if you're getting hate comments, it just means that your influence is actually just going beyond your audience. People who are not your typical audience, the ones who would praise you, are now seeing your video. And obviously, as content creators, we need that. We actually need to get our message out there, you know? And sometimes you're gonna get haters along with that. But there are also sometimes where I've initially gotten hateful comments, I have explained my side, and then they turn it around and say, hey, you know, that makes sense, you know, and we basically end the discussion amicably, okay? So that's a cool thing. Have fun with it. And also realize that thing your content is spreading. If you're getting hateful comments, obviously there are going to be people who agree with you and people who disagree with you. As content creators, we want to make sure that we touch the lives of as much people as we can in the internet. So there, guys, don't let the haters get to you, okay? It's your space, you know, draw the line, know your response to those haters and those different types of comments. Have fun with it and understand that your content is reaching a whole new audience, okay? Find it very important to make sure that you don't feel bad about defending yourself and don't feel bogged down by your hateful comments. And, you know, I'll give you even a bonus tip. Don't waste your energy on the haters, but instead give your lovers and the people who appreciate and support you your best. Because if you think about it, right, when you think about the haters too much, you're dedicating more time to the haters and removing the time that you can be doing more stuff for the people who support you, who love you, who like your content. You're robbing them of your energy. So don't let the haters get the best of you. You know, just have fun with them. But remember that you're making content for your audience. You're not making content for the haters. I disregard the haters. You know, they just leave one comment. They're not gonna watch your next videos anyway. Who cares, right? Who cares about those types of people? Just focus on the people that you're creating content for and who actually support you back. So there you go, guys. Make sure that you think about your approach to haters. Don't let it get to your head. You know, keep it chill, keep it breezy. And if you're enjoying this content, if you want more content that actually helps you become a better content creator and streamer, don't forget to hit that subscribe button and hit that notification bell as well, so that when I release a new video, you get notified. If you also want to hang out with me live and you want to talk about haters and tips and tricks like that on stream, head over to twitch.tv/Norkla. And if you have any questions about streaming and you just want to have a community that supports each other, well, head over to our Discord and the link is down below. That's it, guys. My name is Norkla. All will rise. Lahat tayo hangat.